Okay, I think we got an interesting test for you today. We got two things here to talk about. One, the LUMIX S1RII, and number two, not really a thing, but River here. You got a YouTube channel or something? What's it called?
Tech Through the Lens.
Tech Through the Lens. Go check that out. You arranged the shoot, so I appreciate it. You got the model, you got the space. Here's the idea. It's not just about, does the LUMIX S1RII have rolling shutter? That's been covered, and I covered it numerically. But based on the response, I've been feeling like people don't necessarily know what 20 milliseconds means. What's 10, what does 10, 30, whatever. So if I say 37 is crazy bad, and then somebody else shows a clip where they said, oh, the rolling shutter wasn't bad. Was that at 37? What does it mean, right? So what we want to do is we want to give you maybe 4 or 5 speeds of rolling shutter, probably in the corner, I'll put the milliseconds. And then you can decide for yourself where you draw the line. And this isn't just useful for the S1RII, but the reason why we're using the S1RII is that it has so many modes that we really can probably show you like 5 different rolling shutter speeds on one camera. Specific to the LUMIX that I want to give you guys a tip that I think might work well. It doesn't matter whether you do 5.9K or you do 4K, but if you shoot in 48P, for the intention of putting it on a 24P timeline, so not for slow motion, I mean you could slow motion it, but the idea is this, it comes at a slight crop. Anything above 30 will have this like 11% crop in 16:9. But if you're willing to give up that 11%, the read speed on this thing jumps up significantly from like 23 milliseconds to like 15. That's like going from like an S5II to like a stacked sensor, like a A1, Z8 and 9, R5II, whatever. So it makes a significant jump up. The dynamic range will be the same as any of the other off modes. As soon as you go above 30, dynamic range expansion off is forced. So you're still gonna get that like 11.9 stops on the medium score. Still good, still gonna be good dynamic range. You're just gonna be half a stop worse than if it was on, but faster than if you shoot 4K 24. So theoretically, you could shoot in that mode all the time. You could shoot 4K 48, crank your shutter to 360 degrees with the intention of just drop framing the other 24 frames, and you would have a fast readout mode. That's the best way to get a fast mode on this camera. You're using a monitor so you can record the on-screen stuff. The subject detection turned off. It was fine though with the open gate, which I think was an issue with the previous cameras. Like open gate didn't work when HDMI connected. Now this one I believe is 8K with HDMI turns off subject tracking. And we can even confirm that to make sure. Yeah, it's not an option. So I didn't mention that in my video. I'm only just telling you guys now that I just noticed that when you have HDMI connected and you're shooting 8K, no subject detection. Thank you. There's one more thing that I want to do a quick test on, because I wasn't aware of this when I had my brief and when I made the first video, which is that cropless EIS mode that I talked about in my video that corrects a lot of the corner wobbles and distortions that you get, like, just not rolling shutter related, but just with IBIS when you're like bouncing around on wide angle lenses, how sometimes the corners go all weird. Cropless fixes that, but apparently it also does some like geometric corrections that can improve the appearance of rolling shutter. This is 20 mil with cropless on. I'm just gonna try and... I don't vlog in general, but I don't think that I would vlog like this. Ho! Ho! And then river. Not crazy, but like a little bit of a wishy-wishy, you know? And then if you cut, you can turn cropless. And then do one of your little wishy-wishies. Okay, so we shot for, I don't know what, two and a half hours?
Yep.
We went through two batteries fully. That was start and stop recording. Even though we did a lot of open gate, no overheating in the start stop. I know that I mentioned that open gate will overheat if you just roll all the way through, but start stop, no warnings, nothing like that.
No.
But you will chew through batteries. That's something, we guess what happened, it did happen. As far as the rolling shutter, I observed some things. When we were on the open gate DR-Yon, you would notice it was a bit sloppy.
Mm-hmm.
You seem to start accepting it at the base resolutions of DRE off, which is like the 23 zone. But if ever we did the 4K 48 thing, you were like, oh wow, this is much faster. And that's that like 15 zone.
So for me, like a lot of the stuff that I shoot, it's a lot of like dolly in, dolly out. And for stuff like that, the rolling shutter wouldn't affect me. But if I have to do something with like a lot of movement where I really need to be precise, the rolling shutter almost makes it feel a bit laggy, and I hit my end marks a bit sloppier. And like the way I was hitting my end marks today on a real shoot, that would get you fired. Like it was just so much harder to hit your end marks. And like as an operator, I was like, this just doesn't feel good to operate. Like I didn't.
And anytime you stepped heavier, the whole frame, like it was like, whoa, 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 all the way up.
Yeah.
So you also have to be operating extremely well if you want to use that open gate DR-Yon for more movement.
Yeah. The actual performance of how I operated felt a lot worse on the slower rolling shutter modes versus the faster ones.
Rolling shutter doesn't affect anything I do. Mm. I'm on a tripod, you know what I mean? And again, yeah, if you have really good stabilization or really good controlled movements or really good gear around it, I feel like you could probably get away with everything.
Because DR-Yon is almost like a bonus mode, like it gives you a little bit more dynamic range. It doesn't like necessarily hurt your image quality. So I feel like a camera like this, I just wouldn't use DR-Yon ever.
But anytime I gave him the 4K 48, which is like 48, 50, 60, they're all the same. Anytime I gave you that, you were like, this
felt
is great.
Felt way better.
So yeah, you give up half a stop and you give up a little bit of that crop because your DRE off and you're 10% cropped in, but you didn't seem to really complain about the crop.
Because I'm mainly coming from like a red camera ecosystem, I'm used to cropping, so I don't, like, I'm like, ah, you just always crop.
Yeah.
So the cropping isn't as much of an issue because you can reframe, like work with your lenses. The rolling shutter was like a way bigger issue.
Totally. We didn't do as many of the 4K 120s. I think we did one or two, but I started excluding it because you actually give up quite a bit with a 4K 120. Mm-hmm. Exposure went wonky. The crop was a little bit more significant. Autofocus seemed to take a hit. So I wouldn't say 4K 120 is a rolling shutter fix, whilst it is the fastest, but also the image gets worse. Some of the tests online I saw, detail goes way down because now it's line skipped. So I wouldn't necessarily call that a fix. But the 4K 48, drop half your frames, I think that's a reasonable solution. And you didn't seem to complain about it once when it was on.
Fine.
Okay, enough rolling shutter ranting.
Cool.
Thanks, River, for setting this up. Hopefully this was useful to you, audience. Hopefully you can look at all the different tests and decide for yourself where your rolling shutter threshold is. And then hopefully that informs your buying decisions, right?
Yep.
All right.